this thing happened in 1989. Started in 1989, whereby we had Chogum, Commonwealth Head of Government meeting,
was
held in Chogum on 18th to 24th of October. During that time, they had a declaration Langkawi on environmental management, and because it was the declaration fall on 21st October. So the government decided that we must remember the day.
Right.
So that's why MASM came in, Lingua Alam Sekitar. But what we've done is we extended to 1 week. So we call it Malaysian Environment, which is celebrated every year.
Every year.
From 21st to 27th
October.
So this is the 23rd celebration.
Wow. That's great.
Okay.
So different year, you will have different theme.
Yeah.
What's the theme this year?
This year is actually, it's a continuity of last year's theme. Last year, we were using smart partnership towards a sustainable environment.
Okay.
So this year
is
yes, sustainable lifestyle going.
I like the yes part.
Yeah.
So we want a continuity. Last year we launched a big event in Pradaya. So we want to continue it. This time we push it to the state, so that we have better cooperation with the state.
Nice. Okay, so I'm sure there's a lot of activities being planned out throughout the whole event, so probably you can share with us among the activities.
Okay, among the activities,
yes.
The most top activity is our Debat Alam Sekitar. Debat Alam Sekitar is a debate between the institution of higher learning, which the final and the quarterfinal will be held in Kedah, in UNIMED. The quarterfinal is in UNIMED from 29th to 30th, and the final will be on the 1st November from 2 to 5 p.m. That is the biggest event.
That's the highlight.
That's the highlight. The second highlight is Anugerah Langkawi. Anugerah Langkawi is given to individual and to a corporate sector this year, whereby the plaque is signed by Duli Yang Maha Mulia Sri Paduka Baginda Yang di-Pertuan Agong.
I see.
And then it also come with a price of 10,000 ringgit. Also will be held on the same day, the prize giving ceremony.
That's great.
So the program starts from 7:30 a.m. till 5 p.m. That is the morning session. Then we have another session 8 to 10 p.m. With officiated by Menteri Besar of Kedah, Datuk Sri Haji Muklis Tun Mahathir.
And aside from the activities, this year apparently we were told that it's also a rebranding of the Rakan Alam Sekitar. Maybe you can tell us more about
that. Rebranding Alam Sekitar was already done. Already done last year.
So you're making it a step further.
We just enhanced the program. We already enhanced the program.
Right.
But we continue the program in Kedah.
In Kedah.
Another program we will be having in Kedah is fishing competition. Then we have Enviro Walk. Enviro Explorers. Then we have Enviro Golf. Then we have exhibition and other activities.
Can the viewers still be a part of all the activities mentioned? Like the fishing, the explorers?
Yeah. It's open to everybody.
I see.
Except for the debate lah.
For the debate.
Debate is only for students.
Among universities.
Okay, so that means we can still go fishing.
Fishing can. Yes,
you like that. No problem.
Okay, Mr. Sifa. Now, let's speak on the awareness of Malaysian. So, I think, compared to before, now we are more aware on how to preserve the environment. You see, a lot of efforts has been done, initiatives taken by the government to enhance the and also to beautify a lot of places. The river project is going to be implemented soon, and our hot spots also. So what do you think the level of awareness among Malaysians,
is it enough or
we need
still
more?
Actually the awareness is already there, only thing the people have to give a push and they must put it in practice. We are coming out with the indicator because there is no no way that we have an indicator to measure. So the government is coming out, the department is coming out with the indicator. It should be ready by end of this year, the indicator, to measure.
To measure?
To measure the awareness level among the public. We are coming out with the indicator. Previously, we don't have anything. We only depend on feedback from people. And then the response from people. That's how we get the feedback. But now, we are coming out with an indicator where we can measure. Where all the sector will be involved.
Do you think that the youth, particularly lah,
yeah.
The Malaysian youth, the younger generation, are getting more aware and getting more, most importantly, more conscious in terms of preserving our environment?
I think they're already a big increase. You see, we have Rakan Alam Sekitar, membership of Rakan. We have almost more than 200,000 people have joined the club. We call it Rakan Alam Sekitar, who have become a member, and they are becoming the eye and ear for the department.
I see.
They are also involved in this program in Alostar.
Okay, Zibar, you did mention the awareness is there, but we need to put into practice. Now, when you speak of practice, like, how do we put into practice?
Yeah.
People must love the environment by planting trees. Don't throw any rubbish into it. Whatever you throw, it is going to reach the river. So you block the river, then you create flood.
Yes.
And then impact on the flora and fauna of the river. So there's a direct impact. So it's important that everybody should practice every day how to preserve and conserve the environment. I think people already aware. During school, they already taught.
Even starting from home, it's as basic as that. You know, you begin everything from home.
If you use aircon at 25 degrees, you increase 1 degree. Something like that. If you use 18, then you increase 1 degree. You save. The cost of electricity will go down. You preserve the environment. Something like that.
Right.
If you're not using the switch, better off it.
Since it's going to be held in Kedah this time around, what are your expectations in terms of the people who will be attending? I mean, compared to the last 22 years, you know, since it's been held, right, this event. Let's just say compared to last year, what are your expectations?
We are expecting around 10,000 crowd for the day event, and for the night event, almost 3,000 crowd, all sectors.
So everyone can still come and be a part of the whole event.
No problem. Everybody are welcome, and we hope that more people will join us.
No charges, huh?
No charges. Everything is free.
That's a big question. They're waiting
for that. We spend a lot of money.
Is there any entry fee or no?
No entry fee. Nothing. Even the exhibition booth is free. Including
that's
the exhibition
nice.
Booth. All is free.
So it's going to happen at Tasik Darul Laman in Jitra, Kedah on the 1st of November 2014. For more information, the audience can also go to www.doe.gov.my. Correct? Yep. So DOE stands for Department of
Facebook,
Environment.
Facebook, yes. Rakan Alam Sekitar.
Facebook Rakan Alam Sekitar. That is the key word for you to go to. And also, Rakan Alam Sekitar also has their own website under the DOE, which is RAS. .doe.gov.my.
Correct,
right?
So
betul, eh?
You got it right. You got it right. Spot on. Okay, so we would like for you to invite everyone watching to join and be a part of this amazing Environmental Week 2014.
Yeah.
On behalf of DOE, we would like to invite all residents of Kedah, including other part of the state, to join us to spend a day to preserve and to enhance that environment. Thank you.
Okay.
All right. Wonderful.
Thank you, Mr. Siva.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Siva. I wish you all the best with the event. We hope to make our way to Kedah.